As a dry eye patient, you may find yourself having all kinds of extra tests done by your eye care provider. One such test that helps us immensely in both diagnosing your dry eye as well as monitoring the effect of your treatment is the Schirmer test. Today, I'll tell you what it is, what it measures, and what you can expect as the patient if you're having it done. Welcome to Eye School with Dr. D, where my goal is to arm you with the knowledge you need to take control of your eye health and have the best vision possible. Like and subscribe for videos every week. You've made it to Eye School with me, Dr. D. In today's lesson, we're going over one of the most basic dry eye diagnostic tests that measures your tear volume, the Schirmer test. Before we get started, Eye School is all about eye education. If you found this video because you were searching for information on dry eye syndrome, I have a playlist that I'll leave here for you to check out. There's all kinds of education there about dry eye and blepharitis that I hope you'll find useful. One important measure when it comes to dry eye is the volume of tears your eyes are actually producing. The Schirmer test is an old school method of testing the amount of tears your eyes actually produce in a short period. We use a small piece of filter paper with a little measuring tape on it to see how much tear volume you have. This here is how they look. You open the pack and it's this little tiny strip right here that goes in your eye. Before the test, we instill a topical anesthetic like proparacaine to eliminate reflex tearing. Of course, if you were to put a piece of paper in your eye is going to water and tear up artificially. And those are called reflex tears, and that's not what we're trying to measure. So we numb your eye first so that the tears measured are the basal tears that your eyes naturally produce. After you're numb, the strip is folded and instilled in the corner of each of your eyes. We have patients just relax and close their eyes and wait for 5 minutes while the paper filters wick up their tears. After 5 minutes, the papers are removed and we're able to see how many tears you produce. In a 5 minute period, normal tear production is more than 10 millimeters. Normally, both eyes will produce about the same amount of tears. Producing over 10 millimeters is great, but producing too many tears during the 5 minute time period may indicate a problem as well. Excessive watering, or what we call epiphora, is caused by a number of things, including poor lid apposition to the eyeball itself. So like if your eyelid was pouting forward and not able to hold the tears well, or even a blocked drainage canal. Less than 10 millimeters of fluid indicates that you're not producing enough tears. This is common in dry eye syndrome, but it can also be true in eye infections, corneal ulcers, or say if your lacrimal gland is not working properly for another reason other than dry eye. After the test, your eyes will be numb, so be careful not to rub them too hard. The biggest thing people notice when they have the paper strips in is potentially feeling them a little bit even though their eyes are numb. However, normally it doesn't hurt, it's just an awareness that the paper is there. Your doctor may do this test more than once at your follow-ups to monitor whether or not prescribed dry eye therapies and in-office treatments are working for you. So I hope that helped you understand a little more about the diagnostic test that we perform for dry eye. Let me know in the comments if you've ever had a Schirmer test done and what your score was. That's it for today's Eye School lesson. Class is dismissed.